My name is Boris Johnson. I was in prison from 1975 to 2014 for attempted murder of a police officer.
When he was sentenced to life without parole in 1981 for the murder of Robert LaMonica in Braintree, Weitzel was 28. Now he's 65.
40 years. That's how long Craig Coley has spent behind bars for a crime he has always said he never committed. Now Simi Valley Police are working to set him free.
You guys are gonna wanna watch to the end of this video because you won't believe how long the person at number one spent behind bars. Well, how's it going, you guys? I'm your host for this one, Landon Do Not Sing, and welcome back to another Most Amazing Top 10 video. And you know what? Let's just jump right into this one. This is the top 10 scary inmates who have served the most time in prison. Starting off this list, and at number 10, we have Howard Christensen, who spent 64 years in prison. He was sentenced to life without the possibility of parole. This was after he murdered a teacher back in 1937. He was only 16 years old at the time of the crime, and he didn't do it alone. A 17-year-old was his accomplice, but he couldn't handle facing prison time, so he hung himself in prison. But for Christensen, he outwaited his prison sentence for a chance to see freedom, and it actually happened for him. When he was 80 years old and 64 years later, his sentence was overturned and he was paroled. He passed away 2 years after being free at the age of 82 years old. Richard Honeck is up next at number 9 on our list. This is a man who has been to prison since he was 22 years old and spent the next 64 years and 44 days staring at prison bars. He was sentenced in 1899 for the murder of a former school friend. When Honeck was in prison, he was all over the media, and for some reason he became very famous. He received a mailbag of like 2,000 letters, including a proposal of marriage. There was even employment offers. Is this real life right now? What the heck is going on? This guy's getting employment offers? I mean, who wants to employ him? In prison, he was only allowed one letter per week, but luckily he was able to spend 64 years in prison. So I did the math a little bit here for you guys. That works up to 3,328 letters he was able to open during his time spent in prison. Maybe we should have given him more time to, you know, give him more time to open up even more letters. Honeck was actually released from prison at the age of 84 years old, and he was able to live to the age of 97 years old. So that's 13 years of freedom. Number 8, we have Clarence Marshall, who is known as the person who served the longest time in prison in Michigan. He spent 64 years and 70 days in prison. He was sentenced to life in prison on one count of armed robbery and another of unarmed assault with intent to rob and steal. He was sentenced back in 1952. In 2012, there was a public hearing to consider his parole. Well, 3 years after that hearing, he was released from prison and he was granted parole in 2015. Marshall was 84 years old when he became a free man. William Herons, the man known as the Lipstick Killer. Well, he is the longest serving prisoner in Chicago. He served 65 years and 181 days in prison before he passed away in prison. Well, he comes in on our list at number 7. William George Herons was an American convicted serial killer who confessed to 3 murders in 1946. He was called the Lipstick Killer because he would always write a message at the crime scene with a lipstick. Years after the confession, he tried to take back his statement, saying that he was a victim of coerced interrogation and police brutality.
This was a confession story, and there wasn't any confession story. They made it up. Later on, they admitted that they did. But that didn't help me.
He was given a life sentence with the possibility of parole, but he died in prison at the age of 83 years old. He passed away from diabetes. One of the youngest people to be convicted and sentenced on our list is next up at number 6. We have Joseph Ligon, who is still in prison for a crime he committed at the age of 15 years old, which always sparked the debate of how young can a person be before they are allowed to be given an adult sentence of like life in prison. Ligon was 15 years old and he's still in prison almost 66 years later. He was sentenced to life without the possibility of parole for a murder. But it took a US Supreme Court 66 years to declare that life without the possibility of parole, well, it was classified as unconstitutional for juvenile murderers, so he was released. Number Number 5, we have a man who served 66 years out of 123 days. We're talking about Johnson Van Dyke Grisby. He was sentenced to life in prison after he killed a man in a bar fight. Grisby was actually able to outlive his prison sentence, and he was released at the age of 89 years old. For some reason, he returned back to prison, and he volunteered there. He volunteered for the hard jobs in prison. Grisby was convicted of second-degree murder in 1908, and he was eventually paroled from Indiana State Penitentiary in Michigan City in 1974, which means he served out just over 66 years. He was 89 years old when he saw freedom. When he was released, he was able to live another 12 years before he passed away at the age of 101 years old. We have John Phillips at number 4. Phillips' prison sentence is still ongoing, but as of right now, at the time of this recording, Phillips just passed his 67th year in prison. He is known to be the longest serving prisoner in North Carolina. Phillips was convicted when he was just in the 9th grade, and he was arrested and charged with sexual assault that landed him in prison for a very long time. He took a plea deal to avoid the death penalty, and he received life in prison. Now at the age of 85 years old, he has lost all desire to live in the real world. A lot of these convicts, when they leave prison, they're just given like $20 and a bus ticket to get to where they want to go. But how do you know where you want to go? You've been locked away for almost 70 years. So many changes in that time. If Phillips did leave prison, it would almost be a death sentence to him, because how would he even survive? You lose so much contact with the outside world, it leaves you confused and leaves you foreign in your own country. Also, Phillips is almost 90 years old with no pension, no money coming in. How would he work? So staying in prison is just the best situation for him. He gets food, he always has a shelter, and he always has, you know, something to do. Moving into number 3, we have talked about this man before on this channel. You know, we've talked about him many times, not for good reasons. We're talking about Paul Giddle Jr., who served out 68 years and 245 days, so almost 69 years in prison. We talked about him before because he's actually known to be the longest serving inmate who was able to outlive his prison sentence. Giddle Jr. was only 17 years old when he went to prison. He was convicted of second degree murder in 1911. Giddle Jr. was actually released early for good behavior, so he was granted parole in 1974, and that was when he was 80 years old. He has absolutely no family members or people that he knows because he grew up in an orphanage, and he chose to remain in prison for 6 more years, so he was actually released earlier. But he was finally forced to leave the prison, and he was placed in a nursing home at the age of 86 years old, and he was able to live out his days until the age of 93. At number 2, we have Francis Clifford Smith, who is currently still in prison. He is known right now as the longest serving inmate who is still alive, and he is still serving prison time. Right now, at the time of this recording, he's at 69 years and about 50 days. He's coming closer and closer to that 70 year mark. Right now, Smith is known to be the oldest prisoner in the United States. He was actually sentenced to death for a murder. He murdered a night watchman during a robbery at a yacht club. He was incarcerated back in 1950, just 2 hours before his scheduled execution. Something happened. His sentence was overturned from the death penalty, and it was changed to life in prison. So now he has a chance of becoming the person who has served the longest amount of time in prison. I'm not sure if you really want to be known for that. This man was born in 1924, making him currently 94 years old. Do you guys think he's too old now to like be harmful to society? Should we let him out of prison? Also, even though this man is known to be the oldest living person to have served the most amount of time in prison, not much public information exists about this guy. All I really know is that he was 24 years old when he was sentenced, and in 1967, which is the same year the Toronto Maple Leafs won their last cup, well, he was able to escape prison for 11 days. Finally, number 1, we have the only person on this list to have served over 70 years behind bars. That is a very long time. We're talking about Charles Fossard, who spent 70 years and 303 days in a prison in Australia. Fossard was a French-Australian homeless man who murdered an elderly man for his boots. Clearly, this man was insane, so he was quickly sent to the J Ward Mental Asylum in Victoria, Australia, and he was left there for the next 7 decades. Fossard was admitted to the prison in 1903 at the age of 21 years old, and he wasn't able to outlive his prison sentence. He actually passed away while in prison in 1974 at the age of 92 years old. He is known as the longest serving patient at the facility and the longest serving convict on this list. A record for sure you don't want to have, and Francis Clifford Smith, who I just talked about, has a real shot at breaking this record. So I don't know how he feels about that, or if he even knows that he's so close to breaking the record. And if he's released early, does he make a decision on like staying in prison a little bit longer? Because at least he did something in life. I don't know. Well, there you guys have it. I just want to say thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I'll see you guys all in the next Most Amazing Top 10 video.